So I've been utterly covered in wires and electrodes. I think I have 21 electrodes. Hi, this is Jules, founder of Reviva and inventor of PureTone technology. It's Monday, the 12th of May, 2025, and I'm really excited because I'm about to fly from London to Berlin to kick off the first ever clinical research study into our PureTone sleep tracking technology. I've just arrived in Berlin, and of course my first bite for breakfast needs to be a pretzel. So here I am in the sleep lab. I've just met the team and I've explained to them the equipment and what we're doing. So this is what it's going to look like. We've got actually two phones set up here, and so we can test two different placements of the device and compare the signals. I'm going to sleep here this evening and get hooked up with all the various bits of equipment that they use in the sleep study. Anyway, I've been up for a long time, woke up very early this morning from the flight, and I'm feeling a little bit tired, so I'm going to have a bit of a nap, which is also going to give us an opportunity to test the signal. So I'm going to have a bit of a lie down here, and the team back in London can then process the signals that we're getting from these two phones. And we can just check that everything is looking good for the study. So the data from our test run looked really good. Now I've got a few hours to enjoy a very, very sunny Berlin. So behind me is the iconic TV tower of Berlin, which I think serves as a wonderful visual metaphor for our PureTone technology. That tower cuts into the sky like a fine line, and our PureTone signal is something very, very similar. It is a very precise beam of acoustic energy at a frequency above what we can hear, so to us it is completely silent. Our technology analyzes reflections of that beam of acoustic energy, interprets it into information about movement and about breathing and about sleep. So I'm walking around Berlin and I've just found this really, really cool building. Look at that. And it is called 50 Hertz. That's like 50 times a second. And of course our PureTone is so much higher than that. Our PureTone is closer to 20,000 Hertz. Actually, something really cool. We're going to try a new frequency, which is a bit higher than 20,000 Hertz, because 20,000 Hertz, despite being a nice round number, actually doesn't work well with our technology. It's not an optimized frequency. It so happens that one of the optimized frequencies, which we're going to run in the experiment tonight, is 20,250 Hertz. Really cool, because this is the year 2025, and it just so happens that one of these great frequencies we can use is 2025 zero Hertz. Joy, I love numbers. The fact that we can run this technology tonight on 2025 and zero Hertz is super cool. So my wife, Vanessa, has given me very clear instructions for this evening, which is make sure that you snore. And one of the best ways to increase the odds of that happening is beer. And so, it's time for some beer. I'm sitting in front of a Berlin museum called the Futurium, and I've chosen to sit here, right now, because I think the PureTone technology is the future. It's something so profound, so powerful, so simple, yet it's not been kind of discovered. It's really incredible because, you know, it's just using this kind of completely ubiquitous technology which is everywhere, and it's got the power to see our breathing and our movements and to actually improve our lives. These capabilities are just there on everybody's smartphone, and nobody knows it. Nobody has discovered it. It just feels strange. It feels strange that I do truly think that this technology can have so much impact. And yeah, you know, I think I'm the person who's found it and really realized what it can do and how to use it and how to harness it, how to focus it. Yeah, so maybe I'll be there in history with the inventors, the great inventors. Michael Faraday, I was thinking about today. He made great discoveries. So maybe I'll be up there with the greats. Or maybe, like Little Mermaid, I will disappear like froth in the ocean. And either one is fine. But I'd like to do more than disappear like froth, because yeah, I think this can do good. And I think the world needs some good. So I'm back in the sleep lab and I'm about to get wired up for my overnight sleep study. The first proper patient for the study has also arrived. He's going to be sleeping in the room next door, which is really, really exciting. We've looked to recruit just a real broad and kind of normal, ordinary set of people to get a very kind of representative cross study of the population. A lot of the conditions are in place to have a snory night. Which I do actually want to have, because yeah, it's going to provide some really interesting data. Obviously, I'm the guy who made SnoreLab in response to my wife complaining about my snoring on a cold winter's night back in 2011, and me just not believing her that it was happening. And as is often the case, my wife was completely right, but I did need to build a whole app to record it and measure it to actually get the evidence of that. And that was, yeah, obviously kind of the makings of my career, and has led down the very interesting avenues which have led me to a sleep lab in Berlin testing out PureTone technology, which we hope and think is really the next generation of sleep tracking technology using smartphones. So this is a really exciting moment. My first ever PSG sleep study alongside our very innovative smartphone-based sleep analysis technology. So I've been utterly covered in wires and electrodes, and I think I have 21 electrodes tracking my brain activity, and I have straps around my chest and an oxygen sensor on my finger and a cannula to measure the air that's passing through my nose. I think it's fair to say that our PureTone system, which is just here, is never ever going to replace all of this equipment. And, you know, we have here is really kind of the gold standard of sleep tracking. It's worth saying that there are other forms of sleep tests and sleep studies that don't require you to have all of this. So if you are concerned that you have sleep apnea, which is a very, very common condition, you can do home sleep studies, which are much simpler than this, and they just use a few sensors on your body and can still do a very good sleep analysis and a very good diagnosis. But generally what they don't do is all the brain states. So these electrodes are really about tracking the sleep stages, which are really defined by what's going on in your brain. And so it's going to be really fascinating to see what emerges from all of this. So we're about to do a calibration test to see that all of the equipment is working correctly. So yeah, he's going to speak over the loudspeaker and tell me some things to do. So it's now the morning after the sleep study. Well, the official sleep study ended a few hours ago. It started quite early in the evening and ran for 8 hours. Pretty wild. It was not comfortable having these wires everywhere. And so I woke up quite a few times and had some dreams. I felt like I was dreaming a lot. Apparently I did snore. I'm gonna see the results in the next few hours. The good news is that the participant who was in the neighbouring room did sleep fine, as well as is can be expected in this environment and with all this equipment. So that's really good. Looking forward to seeing results. I didn't come here looking for good sleep. I came here looking for data, and I definitely got some data. So I've just left the lab. The initial results looked fantastic, so I'm really excited to see the data arriving from more of the study's participants, which is going to happen over the next couple of months, starting very, very soon, so it's going to roll quickly. Looking through my EEG was very, very interesting, and there was definitely some things that in there that I'm very excited to explore more, but we didn't have time for that today, and I'm really, you know, looking forward to seeing the next chapters in this story. So I hope you've enjoyed watching this video, and I will certainly be making more of these, so stay tuned.